Welcome back, everyone. In this video, I will discuss how the properties of log can be used to linearize an exponential function. The reason we want to linearize a function is because the linear form of the function can be used to fit an experimental data. From the fitted data, we can often extract useful information about the system that we are studying. An example of this is that linearizing the exponential function that relates reaction rate as a function of temperature gives us information about the reaction's activation energy and its requirement for molecular collision. So our goal is to convert the exponential function form, which we know is y equals a times e to the power of bx, to a linear function form, which is y equals mx plus b. Graphically, we want to take the exponential function plot and make it look like a linear plot or a line. It turns out that logs can be used to help us in the process. So how do we linearize an exponential function? First, we start with the exponential function, y equals a times e to the power of bx. We then take the natural log of both sides of the equation. Using the addition property, we can write the equation as ln of y equals to ln of a plus ln of e to the power of bx. Using the power property, the equation becomes ln of y equals ln of a plus bx times ln of e, which is just 1. Rewriting the equation at the end, we get ln of y equals bx plus ln of a. The reason the equation is written this way is because the equation now has the form of a linear function, y equals mx plus b. We can see here that the y-axis is now ln of y in the exponential function. The slope is the b parameter from the original exponential function. The x-axis remains the same, and the y-intercept is now ln of a from the original exponential function. So as you can see, we have just converted an exponential function into a linear function. At this point, you can fit the function with a linear equation, for example, using Microsoft Excel, as you learn in Chem 11. The fitted data will provide you with the values of the a and b parameters that are part of the original exponential function. This wraps up our review of logs in chemistry. Now what you have to do is use the information you just learned to complete the lab questionnaire on the right. Remember that you can always contact me to ask further questions.